Cantinella's here with Marcus Allen at the Good Day Sacramento Station.
We're actually in the green room, too. This is where all the fun stuff happens.
How many years does it take to become a news anchor?
How many years to become a news anchor?
Yes.
Times have changed. Back when I first got into television, anchors were dedicated journalists. Now, anchor is used in the most liberal way you can use the word anchor, because I'm an anchor. I think in our situation, it means I'm the guy behind the desk, because I'm not a journalist. I didn't go to any kind of journalism training, nor did my degree have anything to do with journalism. I'm just a radio guy who started doing TV.
Who idea was it? At the beginning of your segment of your show, you have each star saying, I would never watch market movies.
One of my best friends is the head of Warner Brothers Feature Film Publicity. And she tells me stories all the time about how the celebrities shudder anytime, like E, Access Hollywood, or anyone says, hey, do you mind looking right over there and saying, hi, I'm Robert Pattinson, and you're watching E? They hate doing that kind of stuff. So I thought, what if I went and said, hey, do you mind dissing my show? Do you mind making fun of it? You'd be amazed at how quick they are to jump on board that. Like, they love insulting the show. Russell Brand did one that's brilliant. My favorite thing about it, the very first one we did was Matt Damon, and he's done like 12 of them, and we string them all together, and it's, hi, Matt Damon, I would never watch Mark at the Movies. Hey, it's Matt Damon, still not, nor will I ever will watch Mark at the Movies. Hey, it's Matt Damon, congratulations, Mark at the Movies, on your 3 Emmy Awards. I'm still not going to watch. It's pretty funny. You have to see it.
What made you want to expand back into radio?
That was like an arranged marriage, a really bad arranged marriage, too. We're owned by CBS Television. CBS Television also owns CBS Radio. They're trying to integrate and get synergy going. And one of my good friends, one of the funniest, most creative, most talented people in radio, Don Geronimo, came back to Sacramento. He had been here in syndication, and then he came here to do radio, and we got him on Good Day for a limited time. But when we did that, the managers at CBS Radio said, all right, we're giving you Don Geronimo in the morning. What are you going to give us? And it's like a chess game. They go, okay, we'll give you Mark Allen in the afternoons. So I was told, what would you think about going back to radio and doing afternoons? I said, well, let me think about it. And they said, okay, you've thought about it. You're doing it. And so I'm doing it. And I like it. I actually like being back on the radio.
Is there anything else you would like to share?
No, nothing other than you are lovely and should be in this business. I don't know what's taking you so long.
Thank you.
One thing is that anchors take themselves too seriously, and I don't think they should, because you're supposed to be the eyes and ears of what's taking place and relate it back to the community. Well, you look up and you see all these talking heads that look like they were cut from a mold. They look so phony and fake and not real and don't show an ounce of personality, but you're all about personality. I love the look you have going on. You have a face for television and a personality for it, so I wish you all the best in the world.
Thank you.
And when you get your job and you do well and you make it into management and you're an executive producer, will you hire me sometime? Don't forget about me.
I'd love to work
please.
With you.
All right. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
You're awesome.
I'm Caitlin Ellis here with Marcus Allen.
And I would never watch Mark at the Movies. That show sucks.